Bus and tram stations across Germany at a standstill Friday as commuters endure yet another transport strike. 90,000 public transport workers across the country walked off the job to press for better working conditions, particularly reduced working hours and increased holiday entitlement. Now, this comes a day after a strike by security staff at 11 German airports that saw more than 1,000 flights canceled or delayed. Over 200,000 travelers were affected. Philippine officials set to participate in the Singapore Air Show for the first time this month. As Andrea Taguines reports, a Philippine delegation is seeking out investments for the expansion of the Clark International Airport and the development of Filipino aviation personnel.
The Clark International Airport Corporation eyes to serve 4 million passengers this year, or more than twice its passenger count in 2023. CIAC President and CEO Ari Perez says they're banking on more tourist arrivals and the diversion of some flights from the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, or NAIA, to help them reach their target.
The aggressive plans for tourism in the country will be certain that will attract more. Now, with the plans of the DOTR to upgrade the our main gateway, which is the NAIA, imagine when they're going to rehabilitate, some of its operations will be non-operational. And Clark will be ready to serve.
Touted as the Philippines' next main gateway to the world, the Clark International Airport is also setting its sights on additional flight destinations, as well as having more airline and cargo operators. The CIAC and the Basis Conversion and Development Authority hope to attract more of these locators as they join the Philippine delegation to the Singapore Air Show from February 20 to 24.
The intention really for this event is to be able to entice more airlines to mount flights in Clark and entice the the aerospace firms, the logistics players, and even the tourism entrepreneurs to go to Clark, no? Make Clark their next destination for their next business destination. So we really hope that this mission will be very successful.
Perez says they also want to attract investments to improve the so-called airport city as a whole. Their planned flagship projects include the creation of a national food terminal, which is open for public-private partnerships, an entertainment and events hub, and infrastructure for both cars and pedestrians. Perez adds the CRK Direct Access Link is particularly crucial.
It's a link that goes directly, the quickest, the fastest, most convenient access to the airport. Because right now, the existing access leads, it's a maze. It's going further away to the airport if you're coming from the expressways, from SCTEX, from NLEX.
So far, Perez says they've touched base with potential investors such as Surbana Jurong, a subsidiary of Singapore's Temasek Holdings, as well as infrastructure consulting firm Acom. For the transportation department, the air show is also an opportunity to score investments for the education and development of Filipino aviation personnel amid the current global shortage. It says the Philippines is in need of nearly 300 more air traffic controllers.
We only graduate less than 100 every year. And we need to really invest in resources to attract more enrollments and more institutions to provide the education and the equipment and the facilities so that the output of air traffic controllers grows. Our own requirements face the challenge of these controllers who secure their ratings after several years of actual work, being invited by foreign countries to work in the Middle East or in Australia or in New Zealand. So the thrust of the department is to adopt a strategy of producing surplus.
According to Lim, the winning bidder for the NAIA rehabilitation project is also expected to invest in the airport's air traffic control towers and in the training of personnel. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Some sugar-producing areas in the Philippines are bearing the brunt of the El Niño phenomenon. Sugarcane plantations in Cabangcalan City, Negros Occidental, are drying up due to the weather event. But the United Sugar Producers Federation of the Philippines assures the public there is an adequate supply of sugar for the year. The group's president, Manuel Lamata, notes the government has put in place measures that will protect both consumers and farmers.
Because of what the president did, in where he ensured a buffer stock for our country on sugar, we have no problems of our supply thinning out and not being able to service our Filipino people. He approved the PITC to come in and buy our local sugar from the producers. That will boost our meal gate prices.